is inoperable. The abyss of samsara is crossed. And if the abyss is traversed, downfall is avoided. The matrix of the Samantabhadra is the unvarying now. The matrix of the Vajrasattva is incapable of alternation or sublimation. Simple recognition of the nature of being is labeled Buddha. With that realization, nothing to adopt or abandon. Everything is smooth into its unique reality. On the Isle of Gold, all things must be gold. Where there are no parameters, no limitations, deviation is impossible and veils are transparent. So in luminous mind, no downfall possible. The three dimensions are spontaneously, effortlessly complete. And the phrase unimaginable and inexpressible, a mere figure of speech. Sensory appearance is undone. Pure presence self-sprung shines out. And unveiled, without inside or outside, appearances are transparent. In genuine natural disposition, everything shines in supreme reality. Relaxing our body, mind, in satisfaction. Hanging loose like someone who has nothing to lose. Neither tense nor slack, the body mind rests comfortably. No matter how we feel, we abide in the nature of mind. No matter how we live, we stay in the nature of mind. No matter how we move in the nature of mind. In luminous spaciousness, coming and going are impossible. No movement in the victor's dimension. Whatever we say reverberates as mind's nature. Whatever is expressed is articulated as mind's nature. In luminous mind, no verbal expression manifests, for the speech of the victors is ineffable. Whatever ideas emerge are thought as the nature of mind. Whatever concepts emerge are conceived as the nature of mind. In luminous mind, ideas and concepts never truly exist, for the mind of the victors is a thoughtless mind. Absence occurring as anything at all is the Nirmanakaya. Enjoyment is the nature of in the nature of mind is the Sambhogakaya. The absence of any substantial ground therein is the Dharmakaya. The three dimensions as fruition comprise the spontaneity matrix. In the spacious supermatrix of luminous mind, no discursive thought arises. If the ordinary mind is untrammeled by signs of perception, this is the vision of holistic Buddha. Luminosity in essence, like the spacious vault of the sky, without thought or concept, is the supreme meditation. Luminosity in essence, like the spacious vault of the sky, without thought or concept, is the supreme meditation. Nothing but our own nature, unmoving and uncontrived, without mentation, nothing at all generated in the mind, that is reality, naturally disposed, nothing changing in time, the supreme meditation where the movement of thought ceases. Whatever rests in that intrinsic nature is sacred, fearless mind. It is holistic Buddha, free of all attributes. It is unmoving spaciousness that equalizes all reifying concepts. It is the victor's vision matrix, the supreme expanse of our being, abandoning the chains of fabricated body-mind in unfeigned relaxation, regardless of any stirring thought forms. When we abide in the ground of being and stay in that reality, everything is the vast, all-good vision matrix. Free of the stress of compulsive give and take, we are uninhibited, naturally disposed in our very being. The matrix without parameters is a still, all-pervasive smoothness. And all thought forms subsiding by themselves into themselves. This is the Vajrasattva sky-like vision. If we are undistracted from the authentic matrix of luminous mind, though we engage with the mental field, that is also reality. But if that reality is adulterated by any compulsiveness, although the matrix is thought-free and spacious like the sky, we are caught in a cage of reified concepts. We may meditate continuously in that way, but it is mere trance. And trance, said Sakyamuni, is similar to the meditation of the gods. So it is crucial that mind is undistracted and without motivation, remaining in its natural disposition, transcending goal orientation. Since self-sprung awareness in the now is zero-dimensional, no thing or goal or ideal is ever indicated therein. For all mental elaboration has naturally collapsed. Intellectual stratagems and rational agendas have been abandoned, and we familiarize ourselves with the sublime groundless expanse. The one holistic reality is self-sprung awareness in the now. The one holistic view is free of discursive opinions. The one holistic meditation neither lacks nor wants nothing. The one holistic conduct comprises non-dual giving and taking. The one holistic fruition detests moral preference. That is the self-sprung guru vision of spontaneity. The universe, material and spiritual, samsara and nirvana, all experience whatsoever is reality from the first. Since it cannot stray from self-sprung awareness itself, all experience is disposed as the ground of being. That is guru vision. Regarding reality appearing as a multifarious field, without worrying about any perceptual disposition, simply rest in naturally disposed, non-pulsating mind. And we stay naturally in the reality that is the matrix of sameness. Regarding the forms of sensory appearance in a field of duality, by neither focusing the senses nor letting the gaze wander, free of a sense of self or an idea of other, we allow natural clarity to shine in vast, smoothed out openness. In the vision of an all-identical, self-sprung awareness in the now, where free of pulsation, mind is expanded and heightened, experiencing integral space free of outside, inside, and in between, blissful, clear contemplation, free of discursive elaboration, arises. Regarding the vision of reality unmoving in the quiescent ground, no outside, no inside exists, no elaboration of perceptual duality. And since there is no mind that fixates objects as other, nothing exists to get hold of, and no attachment to perception, and nowhere in samsara to take rebirth, there is only the sky. When the mind is not conceived as oneself within, there is nothing to grasp and nothing to become attached, and all habitual assumptions about conditioned existence subside. And the person to be reborn in samsara vanishes. At this point, where outer and inner are both like the sky, delusive experience cannot be conceived or imagined, and we have arrived at the Dharmakaya vision. Touching final resolution, coming and going now barred, we reach the supreme citadel of the Dharmakaya, the pure fields of the all good, the all saturating matrix. If pure presence of the now does not stray from the ground of being, familiarization with it precludes strengthened conditioned existence. And the karma and habit that perpetuate rebirth run dry. Causality resolve, we say that samsara and nirvana are identical, and being in neither conditioned existence nor peaceful cessation, we have arrived at the luminous heart core. That is definitely not a state of one-pointed calm abiding. It is the vision of natural great perfection. When we vacillate, losing the essential grounded space, the intellectual mind at work becomes samsara itself, involving causal concatenation that precludes resolution, and inevitably we fall lower and lower. The supreme secret, the great perfection, on the other hand, never strays from intrinsic spaciousness, and the forms of its creativity naturally dissolve into their source. This vision is the vision of immutable sameness. In this vision, goal-directed endeavor is impossible. So the view, for example, cannot be cultivated. Yet, out of this space where center and circumference are unified, creativity projects its display into another dimension, where it appears as a multifarious variety of the universe. Never say categorically that cause and effect do not exist. The complexity that arises from interdependence is incalculable. The states of samsaric delusion and nirvanic joy are incalculable. A mass of causes and conditions constitutes a sublime synchronicity. When we identify our authentic nature, nothing can be said about it. Likewise, taking authenticity as the path wholly committed, knowing it only in moments of unimagined non-conceptual vision, consumed by it, we are completely, transparently naked. In the supermatrix, afflictive emotion, karma, and habit create aberrational games of magical illusion. To be free of that, please, we resolve causality. Our method is supreme. Never, never stray from the vision of reality. And cherish the excluded middle. This is the crux of my heartfelt advice. One moment. So, we're being brutalized by the difficulty. I understand. I'm with you. It's better than being brutalized by what doesn't work, by what's not effective, isn't it? So we're going to get it one way or the other. We might as well consciously, willingly put ourselves through this ordeal. Very interesting, that message was one of our projects. Someone has a roof off, the roof is off, and they just realized it's going to rain. We just hear it's going to rain. And that's like our situation, isn't it? We have our roof is off, and we think, oh, that's no problem, it never rains. Oops, here comes the rain. Right? So this is like putting a temporary roof on our house, right? When you find out you're in a project and the roof is off and it's going to rain, you better get after it. Better get after it after hours, right? Hustle. Hustle is indicated. So this is just like putting a roof on our house. Oh my gosh, it's going to rain. Because it most certainly is going to rain in this world. The rain of error, so to speak. So we better get this roof on. So here we go. Within the unitary luminous mind, everything the same as the sky, dualistic perception deludes us with causal conditioned existence. Appreciating those baseless delusory appearances as magical illusion, through direct perception, calculation preempted, no trace remains. When anger, dismay, envy, trouble, or irritation, anxiety, depression, or mental pain, fear of death and rebirth, and so on, accompanies negative reaction to unwelcome events, recognize it at its inception as a display of creative power. Do not reject it or indulge it. Do not try to purify or alter it, but rather, without applying view or meditation, in the naturally disposed, smoothed out totality, free of pulsating thought and image, rest without self-consciousness. The self-dissolving, traceless sky matrix of expansive mind then dawns as intense, clear radiance from within. There's our roof. There's our real roof, right? With unconstrained presence that neither is nor is not. Here, we look directly at defocused sensory appearance. Here, because we rest naturally in ungraspable space, here, subliminal value judgment vanishes without trace. And here, unfixated experience wells up from within. This simply is the guru vision matrix in the vastness of the now. In the same way, when we are desirous and joyously fulfilled by easy success, friends, good news, pleasure and wealth, and by places and vistas, such pleasure enriches the mind with joy. Recognize this and naturally disposed, freely resting, uncontrived spontaneity occurs in pristine spaciousness. When a neutral state of unaffected indifference possesses us, no matter what arises, neither pleasant nor unpleasant, recognize it at its inception without repression or indulgence, and it falls into its own naturally disposed reality, where neither differentiation nor exclusion impinges, and dullness is released into the sublime clear light. At night, or whenever sleep overtakes us, lying down, naturally disposed, free from mental pulsation, gross appearances have subsided, and with them our attachment. When attachment to the subtle and very subtle has also vanished, the mind as pure presence in its aspect of unthinking sameness abides in its own nature, free of the aberrations of hope and fear. At this time, all basic thought constructs are released as intrinsic spaciousness, and it is described as the release of samsara into nirvana. As in sleep, so in the self-sprung pristine supermatrix, creative expressions dissolve into essential basic spaciousness, and all the elaboration perceived there as display subsides by itself. In guru vision, such is the involuntary function of self-sprung awareness. In that way, all desirable, undesirable, and neutral mental states, the three poisons, arise in creativity as display, emerging from intrinsic spaciousness as spaciousness, and since that includes everything, nothing excepted, nothing ever moves an iota from intrinsic spaciousness, avoiding anticipation and manipulation of it, the recognition of spaciousness itself and resting therein is crucial. And thereby it naturally subsides, vanishing, released just as it is. Afflictive emotion, karma, and habitual propensities arise as illusory magical display from creativity. And even methods of improvement on the path of liberation arise as illusory magical displays from creativity. Everything arises in the now as display of creativity. And it is crucial to recognize it without modifying it in any way. All the same in posture, same in gait, the same in relation to the ground, transcending circumstance, complexity, and causality. And causality superseded, resting freely, we cherish our natural disposition. This, then, is the peak of the supreme secret approach. Do not speak of it to those of lesser acumen. Keep it highly secret. Interpretation will distort the heart teaching. An exaggerated appreciation is at odds with the vision. Violators of secrecy fall eternally into the lower realms. So the legacy of the sovereign secret approach, this teaching, is entrusted only to the fortunate, fearless few. In short, no matter what situation arises, do not engage in it to improve it or to try to suppress it. For the key is pure presence, naturally disposed, freely resting. Pure presence may occur as pleasure or pain, but if we discriminate between them, we are caught in conditioned existence. Everything that appears in the sensory field is identical, just clarity in the face of the sense organ. Everything that arises in the mind is identical, just the same traceless thought. The juncture of object and mind is identical, just the same binding reaction pattern. In truth, ultimately, every perception is identical, just groundless, baseless appearance. Sensory objects all have an identical tendency, just traceless in their unraveling. Mental states have an identical face, just space when identified. Object and mind are non-dual, just pure open space. Whoever knows this is the heir of the All Good, the Supreme Bodhisattva, the highest Vidyadhara. Therefore, all experience equally absent is identical. Equally apparent and equally empty equally true and equally false, and we may dispense with all antidotes, all striving, all fixation in mindless, marvelous presence, space out in infallible, superlative sameness. It's better to get the ordeals out of the way now, isn't it, than to wait until the rain comes. The rain of error that is coming in this world. It's better to get this out of the way, this ordeal out of the way. That's why we're doing it. That's why we're doing it. It's just work. Look at it as work. We all work. This is just work of a different type, but it is work. So we work at it. All experience is released here and now in luminous mind. An unreleased event is impossible. Samsara is released in the now, liberated as alpha purity. Nirvana is released in the now, liberated as spontaneous perfection. Appearances are released in the now, liberated in their baselessness. Life is released in the now, liberated in its luminous heart. Mental elaboration is released in the now, liberated in its limitlessness. Formlessness is released in the now, liberated as pure potential. Pleasure is released in the now, liberated in its equalized reality. Suffering is released in the now, liberated in the ubiquitous basic expanse. Dispassion is released in the now, liberated in the sky-like Dharmakaya. Purity is released in the now, liberated in its empty authenticity. Impurity is released in the now, liberated in supreme, spacious freedom. The levels and paths are released in the now, liberated in the absence of creative and fulfillment stages. View and meditation are released in the now, liberated in non-discrimination. Conduct is released in the now, liberated in the all good. The goal is released in the now, liberated in the absence of hope and fear. Samayas are released in the now, liberated in the supreme reality. Recitation is released in the now, liberated in nonverbal expression. Contemplation is released in the now, liberated in the absence of a field of thought. Affirmation and negation are released in the now, liberated in the middle way. Dogmatic belief is released in the now, liberated in absence of any ground. Authenticity is released in the now, liberated in absence of any preconception. Inauthenticity is released in the now, liberated in non-critical bias. Karma is released in the now, liberated in its boundless transparency. Afflictive emotion is released in the now, liberated in thorough disinterest. Karmic proclivity is released in the now, liberated in its groundlessness. Karmic result is released in the now, liberated in the discontinuity of experience. Antidotal method is already released, liberated in self-sufficiency, liberated in the vast sky-like expanse of non-dual give and take. Catharsis is released in the now, liberated in non-repression. Repression is released in the now, liberated in sky-like freedom. Hanging loosely is released in the now, liberated by the absence of anything to relax. Resting freely is released in the now, liberated by the absence of anything brought to rest. In short, all conscious sensory perception and all that is unconscious or transcendent, everything is already released in the spaciousness of the now. So any attempt to liberate anything anew is superfluous. It is pointless to try and make effort towards release. So don't try, don't struggle and strive and practice. Don't seek intellectual mind, intellectual truth. Don't meditate, don't contrive meditation. Don't analyze in or after an event. Don't practice the upshot of hope and fear. Don't reject emotional karma. Don't believe in righteous religion. Don't trap yourself, don't cage your mind. In the absence of an objective field, everything equalizes. No discernible point of reference, no object, and no order can exist. The ground collapses, the path collapses, and the goal collapses. In thoughts of good or bad, deviation and error are inconceivable. Committed to equalization, bound in the now, the universe resolved, samsara and nirvana have reverted to ubiquitous spaciousness. The question, what is it? How is it? Lie unanswered. What can I do? Who am I? Likewise, unanswerable. And can we do? What can we do when all our uncertainties have vanished? We can only laugh outright at the absurdity of it. The entire galaxy of delusory constructs, inner and outer, collapses, and linear time melts in the now, self-dissolving, fading into space. Days and dates fade away, months, years, and eons dissolve. The one and the many vanished, sacred and profane both clarified. The delusive ground of samsara and nirvana clarified in its innate spaciousness. Even spaciousness as an intellectually contrived entity dissolves. Whatever we have practiced, however we strive, is useless now. An intellectual gall exhausted, what a great marvel is the sky. This pathless vagrant is one with the sky. Since this floating jeweline sky fortress, lacking foundation, released in the now, arises spontaneously as guru vision, the threefold universe is released as objectless sublimity. People consensually bound in delusory space-time, ignorant of their own intrinsic nature, are corrupted and stupefy themselves. Such delusion, their delusion lies in seeing the absence of delusion as an abyss. Deluded or not, the same luminous mind matrix pertains, and there in the now, neither delusion nor release occurs. Reification of what arises from luminous mind as display entraps us. Both confinement and release are non-dual, the mind and its field non-existent. Do not be seduced into believing that what is mere label truly exists. Pure presence is liberated by Buddha in the now. So do not confine it to the trap of goal fixation. In the now, in the pure matrix of no objectivity, in the luminous matrix that is blissful sky-like root and base, as alpha purity, samsara is not possible. Within the one soul sphere, without edges or corners, the deluded mind holds ideas of unity and differentiation. Within the self-sprung awareness in the now, without causes or conditions, what holds to the samsara process is a luminous, obstructing spirit. Within unlimited, non-spatial spontaneity, attachment to a determinate view is the devil of conceit. Within the non-crystallizing emptiness free of substance and attribute, perverse intellect infers presence or absence, appearance or emptiness. Abandon the cage of determinacy and bias, and know the non-spatial spontaneity that is like the sky. Whatever arises in the six sensory fields, all sound and appearance, all is intrinsic clarity in the undifferentiating, all-inclusive matrix. Let us come to resolution in the now, in that matrix of sameness. Awareness as spaciousness gives rise to all appearance in unitary sameness. Awareness as the ground of being generates all potential. Awareness as the matrix liberates everything without any application. Awareness as luminous mind is the essential universal source. Know all things as pristine purity like the sky. Self-sprung awareness is the vast basic matrix of luminous mind. Undefiled, untouched by samsara, it is luminous. Uncaused, all potentiation as spontaneity, it is luminous. And as pure, clear light, the heart of intrinsic presence, it is mind. In luminous mind, everything, all included, is completely pure. I'm just... Okay. With realization of the original face of what arises out of creativity as display, a sudden reawakening to Buddha may occur. In the absence of realization, oblivious conditioned consciousness arises. In 8 fields of dualistic perception developed from a genetic basis, and yet, however the resultant display of the universe appears, it can never stray from the matrix of luminous mind. And unmoving from the luminous mind matrix, staying in sameness, samsara and nirvana are united and released in the vast guru vision matrix. In the natural disposition, samsara and nirvana are impossible. Goal fixation is impossible in the natural disposition. The 5 emotional syndromes are impossible in the natural disposition. Fragmentation and partiality are impossible in the natural disposition. Self-expression is impossible in the natural disposition. In the natural disposition, nothing ever crystallizes. With self-sprung awareness in the now, consummate and nameless reality, no matter what arises, rootlessly as creativity and display, it falls naturally without confinement or release as natural perfection. Release or liberation is cipher for naturally dissolving without residue. And since everything exists and nothing exists are not contradictory, it is expressed by the words released in the now. No differentiation or exclusivity, just released in the matrix of spontaneity. No union or separation, just released in the matrix of the one soul sphere. No matter what manifests, it is released in the indeterminable matrix. Manifest is form, shining, released just as it is. Audible as sound, vibrating, released just as it is. Perceptible as smell, released in its own spaciousness. Savored as taste, felt as tactile sensations, released in its own space. And thought, apprehended, groundless, unsupported, rootless, always released. Liberation in unity, released in the matrix of reality. Non-duality, released in the sameness of object and mind. Self-sprung liberation, released in the matrix of primal awareness. Spontaneous liberation, released in the pure spaciousness of the ground. Multiplicity liberated, released as the one soul matrix. Indeterminacy liberated, released as the spontaneity of the matrix. Everything liberated, released as the heart matrix. The clear light released, liberated in the stellar matrix. Reality released, liberated in the sky matrix. The objective field released, liberated in the oceanic matrix. Unchanging release, liberation in the peak matrix. Released from the first, released in the matrix of potential. Totality released, liberated in the matrix. Buddha in the now. Totality, total release, release in the now. Liberation in the constantly unfolding matrix. If we gain familiarity with the luminous essence, the luminous spontaneity of things, through the key precepts of non-striving and effortlessness, Buddha in the now is Buddha reawakened. And that is the actuality of the peerless Vajra heart, the essence of the ninefold path, the luminous supermatrix. The sun and moon, clear light mandalas in the vault of the sky, obscured by thick clouds, are invisible. Just so, the luminosity within us is veiled. Just as thick clouds floating in the sky may naturally disperse, so the miasma of causality involuntarily dissolves by itself. And the luminous heart arises by itself in the vault of the sky. But different degrees of acumen require different approaches. Our original face shines like the sun in the matrix of intrinsic spaciousness. It's creativity, without bias, projecting everything as light. filling the land and the oceans with warmth, so that moisture rises as a cloud display that seems to veil our essence and our creativity besides. An impure display of essence and creativity veils the original face of reality that is our heart essence, covering it with a universe of incalculable, delusive appearances. Out of creative power, a wind blows, and similar to the sun's rays, it disperses the clouds. As we realize our original face, this display is experienced as ornamentation. Delusion, released in the now, is now liberated as it stands. And deluded perception and attachment, without denunciation, lie at peace, assuaged in their own spaciousness. The great Garuda's wings develop within the egg, but enveloped by the shell, this is not apparent. When it hatches, instantly it soars into the sky. Likewise, although delusive dualistic perception is already resolved, only when the shell of congealed residue cracks open does the intrinsically clear spontaneity of the pure presence arise by itself. Manifestations of Buddha in Buddha fields fill the spacious sky, and through recognition of the original face, we are liberated in the all-good matrix. As a boundless display of compassion filling the 10 directions, miraculous emanation satisfies the needs of beings. For as long as samsara lasts, such altruistic activity flourishes. Activity that arises out of the naturally settled essence of being as display of our creativity's impartial compassion, abundantly benefiting others. Impure display has completely collapsed, yet transforming emanation suffuses impure beings. By means of the teacher's appropriate responsiveness and by open-minded people's pure aspiration, presently, although incalculable environments exist, countless beings therein being drawn into luminosity, they cannot stray from the spaciousness of the teacher's Dharmakaya. For self-sprung awareness is unrestricted, zero-dimensional, naturally occurring within spaciousness as the highest envisionment, an inconceivable Sambhogakaya array manifests to fearless 10th level Rigzin and Dakinis. It is as if, through the teacher's spacious compassion and the disciple's devotion and virtue, mind's original face surely shines forth as spontaneity. In this self-sprung awareness in the now, itself the Dharmakaya, the all-inclusive display, is a lake of all-knowing, impartial awareness, the one sole sphere of pristine spaciousness. The essence of the Sambhogakaya is natural spontaneity, and the five Buddha families and the five modes of primal awareness, as display of pure presence, fill the entire gamut of the sky. The essence of the Nirmanakaya is the ground of manifest compassion, the display appearing wherever or as whatever action is needed, demonstrating thereby perfectly appropriate activity. These modes of being defy goal-directed endeavor. They shine only in freely resting space as the spontaneity of the now. This supreme secret is disclosing itself at this moment, and since we shall not be lured away from it, even in the bardo, this apex approach of the Vajra heart towers exalted above all progressive graduated approaches. This song of the Vajra heart of reality in its alpha pure nature like the sky occurs as a self-arisen display, neither transforming nor sublimating in unchanging groundless space. It evokes the vast supermatrix, the all that without going anywhere, in the natural state of alpha purity, in unrestricted and zero-dimensional freedom, we may enter the reality of immutable spontaneity. The center of this vast sky-like expanse is our concern, the sovereign self-sprung supermatrix where unmoving everything is released as it stands, where we reach the vast womb of ineffable spaciousness. Such a sky-like adept, his realization certain, composed this short poem from his own experience, in accordance with the formal transmission and the scriptures, the 21 texts of the Mind series, the 3 sections of the Matrix series, and the 4 sections of the Secret Precept series. Through the merit of this work, may all beings, excluding none, without effort, realize the space of alpha purity, and as princes of reality, spontaneously provide mutual benefit in the unalterable, non-sublimating realm of Samantabhadra. Let comfort and ease and prosperity spread everywhere, and as in a pure land, may wishes be spontaneously fulfilled. As the drum of reality beats, the banner of freedom unfurled, fearless awareness is sustained, and Dzogchen revelation increases. As an adept of the apex approach, Longchen Rabjampa composed this treasury of the Dharma Dhatu in the throat of the White Skull Snow Mountain, and it is now completed. So in each reading, we gain a little more, we gain a little more. I caught a lot there. I said, wow, I didn't see that before. I see, oh, wow, little more, see. It sinks in deeper and deeper and deeper. But it's still, you know, it's not easy, it's not so smooth, it's wow, my, you know, it's an ordeal, but certainly. I say, oh, that's what's being pointed to. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. A lot of like, oh, wow. But it's not like a story, is it? Like a beginning and ending, is it? We're saying, okay, well, where's the plot of this? Where's the antagonist, the protagonist, and the hero, you know? And the hero and the villain. Where's the action? Where's the plot? Where's the beginning? Where's the ending? No, it's not like that, is it? It just keeps pointing to the same place over and over and over again. And transcending causality. It keeps pointing to the same, right? Smoothed out sameness, same. So we're certainly not becoming stupider by doing this, are we? Now, we cannot measure how much wiser we're becoming, really, but we can certainly conclude that we are becoming wiser. We just can't put a beginning and ending on it, since what we're pointing to, it does not have a beginning or an ending. So, very great. All those who put themselves through this ordeal are doing something truly great, actually, because it is truly the desire of this teacher and this transmission that all beings everywhere, without exception, be greatly helped by this And it is desired that those who are listening to this, the fearless few, actually become the princes of transmission and greatly benefit everyone everywhere. So certainly it is the whole purpose of all this that we do actually gain greatly from this. And so therefore, this as its purpose, and us as this purpose, we certainly are gaining from it greatly. We're putting a roof over our house before it rains here. And we're not talking too much about how bad the rain is going to be, because it's going to be very severe. I've seen it. In a dream, I experienced it. Good Lord. It's going to rain like it's never rained before. The world is going to be flooded, so to speak, by this intensity of the rain of air. So we want to have this very nice roof to take refuge in, right? We want to take refuge. So we are hustling. Going full blast, putting the pedal down, going full blast. And it's not too much, is it? We did it. I feel fine. Yeah, it's a nice little ordeal there. it's not easy, though, right? Not easy. That's fine. You want to climb a mountain? It's going to be uphill. For sure. But as the more we do it, the more we get acclimatized, right? That's great. Okay. Let us wrap this up and go on to the next intense effort. All right, that's it.